originated from this from your server and the request is from your server. So you could use some of these techniques to minimize the cross-site request thread. So coming to the data security. So when you are dealing with data security, you have two kinds of it. One, you are dealing with security of data at storage, and the next one, you are dealing with security of data while it is in transit. When you are talking about data storage security, encryption is mostly used technique to secure the sensitive data, right? So for columns, let's say if I have a column called credit card number, or if I have a column called password, social security number, you will be encrypting the data and storing in your database. So the best technique to use here is a symmetric key algorithm compared to asymmetric due to its performance. And while you are encrypting, one thing you'll have to ensure is the key management itself, right? The key you're going to choose should be strong enough. You should be able to change your keys periodically, and where you store the key is also essential, right? Do not store the key along with the data, because a person who has access to the data should not definitely have access to the key. So you could also have double security mechanisms, like you could split the key in two different stores so that not a single person can have access to both the key storage. And you could also double encrypt the key sometimes, like, and again both the keys should not fall into the same hand. So these are some of the techniques you can do to further prevent the key access to an unauthorized user. So it's just not enough if you encrypt. The idea is to keep the key also in a very stored in a very secure place, and also to have mechanisms to change your key periodically. Now you could also go in for database encryptions generally, which are available in RDBMS like Oracle, which, and even on SQL, which completely encrypts the database, and you when you access, only when you have the right key you would be able to decrypt and then get the data access. So that will also prevent from unauthorized access of the data to a particular user. You should also watch out for performance when you're going for encryption, because it automatically adds its own overhead, and hence ensure you encrypt only the necessary columns and you do not just go about encrypting the entire data. So that's something that you need to weigh on, whether you need security or performance, and then take a call. Data security while on transit. So transit, we are talking about different point-to-point communication, right? So even a web application, we are first talking about web server to application server, and then end user browser to web server, and then application to database. So user browser to web server, the way to properly secure is using HTTPS connection. And for some data, you could also go in for custom encryption, like you have, let's say, a social security number getting transmitted, and you do not just want to trust your HTTPS connection, you could again go in for a custom authentication, a custom encryption there. Now, from a web server to application server, that is mostly it's a web service call or a REST service call. So for that, you could use standards like WS security, which is for a SOAP. If a web service is based on SOAP, you could use techniques like WS security. You could use message security, which actually encrypts the entire SOAP packet and then sends. You could also use transport security with SOAP services, where the transport layer is encrypted. And again, you have techniques techniques to authenticate the client. You could use claims again here, username, password, and certificates here. So that would actually authenticate who is the caller of the web server. So you could use all of these to authenticate the client as well as encrypt the data that is transmitted from one point to the other. On a REST, if it is a REST-based service, you could use HTTPS-based communication, or you could also deploy some custom asymmetrical encryption. Again, here, when on transit, the best form of encryption is asymmetric. We saw for storage, it's the best is symmetric, and for transit, the best is asymmetric. You could go on for a private-public key kind of custom encryption with REST as well. And you need to go in for a custom authentication. You could introduce authentication headers automatically in your HTTP request and so on. So that's on data security, especially when it is in transit. Now,